The Miss Olympias, they all inspired me. The first time I saw a photo of a woman bodybuilder in my whole life in the pages of a magazine, I had to be around 14 years old. That was the first time I saw a bodybuilding magazine. It was interesting. All these muscular men, and they looked amazing, and these incredibly huge bodies. But when I saw the women that were standing next to those bodybuilders, I was in. I was all in. They were beautiful representations of what a woman could be. And as soon as I saw pictures of Ms. Olympia, Rachel McLish, I knew that I was gonna be a woman bodybuilder. That's what I wanted to look like. I wanted to be just like her. I thought she was sexy. I thought she was powerful. I couldn't believe the condition of her body to be able to be powerful and strong and athletic and muscular and beautiful in the sense of what traditionally has been considered beautiful for women, which is always much smaller, sort of the weaker sex beauty. I hate to say that, but I think it's true. She brought a power to her beauty that I had never seen before. It was a physical power. And I remember seeing pictures of Rachel on the beach with a horse in a photo shoot, and she's wearing Indian fringe, and I'm thinking, I want to look just like that. And I'm going to wear a t-shirt that says Flex on it, and I just, all of it, everything about what she represented spoke to me as a young girl. It's interesting to think about how much has changed since the 1970s, early 80s. 1980 was the first Miss Olympia, and Rachel won. And if you look at the pictures of what women bodybuilders looked like back then, they were so different from what we see today. They probably would be competing on what we call the bikini category. And so things have really changed a lot, but that's what progress looks like. When I started working towards being a legitimate competitive bodybuilder, most women and men looked at me and thought, that's too much. We don't like that. We don't understand why you want big arms that way. And they didn't get it. It wasn't socially accepted. Fast forward 20 years. I get compliments every day. Women want to know how I train my arms. And so that's progress. While I was this teenager looking through all the magazines, Corey Everson was dominating the Olympia stage. I feel like Corey Everson brought what felt like a different level of athleticism. And I think that might be because she had a track and field background. And so part of what attracted me was not just the visuals, because she had this beautiful, perfect body, but it was the idea that these women were physically capable. They were athletic. And that represented a different kind of power. And I saw that in Corey. There are certain women who were competing when I was competing, and women like Linda Murray, who was the most incredible example of muscularity and symmetry and beauty and poise that I don't think the world had ever seen before. Tiny waist and broad, round, full shoulders and quads. I mean, I remember when I saw her and I thought, well, how am I going to do that? But I wanted to. I was so inspired by her. And that was the other thing that inspired me about the women bodybuilders, is that if you're going to be a woman bodybuilder, if you're going to be that athlete, if you're going to be a competitor or not, that you have to have strength of character and a constitution about how you see yourself and how you want to build yourself that tells the world that you don't care about what any other person's idea of beauty is. So you work towards building it and then showcasing it. And that's inspiring. I remember seeing photos of Julia Bergman when I was still a young girl. I think she was on the cover of Women's Physique World, and there is a photo of her that is etched in my brain. I thought, oh my God, this is a beautiful woman. And then later she would become a judge and then back on the Olympia stage, and she would dominate. And then of course I had the opportunity to compete against Julia, which I never would have imagined, but of course it was a fantasy for me. And it was a great honor to be able to compete with her. These women forced you to elevate your game. If you're gonna stand on stage next to them, you better come ready to play. And I think that's probably the coolest thing about competing in our sport. It's a finite group of women from around the world, and we're all there on some level pushing and elevating each other. Hopefully more with friendly competition than not, but every now and then it wasn't so friendly. But it was good. Iris Kyle, the winningest bodybuilder in the history of the sport. I remember being on the stage with Iris Kyle, and she was first call out, always was. And I watched her from my position on the prejudging stage. The woman moved her body like a machine, and I was in awe of her precision. She would just click it all into place when she'd hit the poses. That bitch! I was just like, how could you be that on all the time? And I loved her for it too. You know, these are the type of women, I get chills thinking about it, to be honest with you. These are the kind of women that I've had the pleasure of watching, who've inspired me. You might wonder why I'm talking about the former Miss Olympias and the ladies that inspired me. And it's because I am so excited that for the first time in my life and in my career, I'm going to have the opportunity to meet all of the former Miss Olympias, or at least as many of them as I can, all in one place. Because this year at the Olympia, Wings of Strength is honoring all of the former Miss Olympia winners, and I'm going. My goal is to meet as many former Miss Olympias as I possibly can. I want to collect as many autographed 8x10s to complete my wall of Olympias. And I know that these women are going to continue to inspire me, because they do. So if you love women's bodybuilding like I do, support the women. I don't know, buy tickets, you can go to shows, you can join their websites, you can buy autographed 8x10s. There's a lot of different ways to support women's bodybuilding event, and that's what I'm doing. I'm going to the Olympia, y'all.